A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st May, on the front page you have India cuts off UN panel after J&K report. So this is regarding the Human Rights Council, the Geneva-based organization, which has listed 13 cases in 2018 alone, including of 4 children being killed by security forces. So these on the basis of these reports, now India has cut off with the UN panel. This is the news coverage. This is three UN special rapporteurs sent submission to India and asked for action taken on human rights violation. But India rejected such submissions and said it will no longer engage with them on the issue. Then this is Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India for hike in third party premium rates. So this has full coverage on the business page too. So we'll see it over there too. On page 6, you have stubble burning incidents down in Punjab this harvest season. So it is said awareness of the ill effects have been one of the key reasons for the dip in stubble burning incidents, which are a major cause of air pollution even in the adjoining Delhi region. Then below you have every drop of pollution in Ganga is a matter of concern. So this is National Green Tribunal, which has pulled up National Mission for Clean Ganga for not providing proper action plans. So Ganga pollution is a major cause of concern too. Then on page 9 you have kilogram update to spur revision of textbooks. So the unit kilogram will no longer be defined by physical objects. So up till yesterday as such, you can say kilogram derived its provenance from the weight of a block of platinum iridium alloy housed at the International Bureau of Weights and Measures in France. But now its definition has changed. So that will result in, you know, changes in the textbooks as such too. So you can see the kilogram will be based on the definition of the Planck constant, a constant of nature that relates to how matter releases energy. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Eye on the Monsoon. So this editorial says that states in India must now set up new recharging wells and improve existing ones on a war footing. Because, you know, after the annual summer monsoons, hopes are which are of particularly high to normal rainfall, which is vital to agriculture, but steps need to be taken so that, you know, monsoon is beneficial for the people. So having these recharging wells are important. So here you can see, as it is written, that a normal summer monsoon over the subcontinent brings widespread prosperity but does not guarantee a uniform speed. So there are steps which the government needs to take into. Then this is Yemen's woes. So the Saudi airstrike on Sana'a, the capital of Yemen, it says risks tipping the country back to pre-ceasefire days. So the escalation of tensions in West Asia, we had seen how the Houthi rebels had targeted Saudi oil installations and, you know, some certain ships as such too, which are blamed on Iran, because Houthi rebels of Yemen are said to be backed by Iran, and we already know about the Saudi-led coalition which is fighting a war in Iran against the Houthi rebels. So the escalation of tensions here is discussed. The lead article, why the BJP is not invincible in Uttar Pradesh. So this is an editorial talking about, you know, the development, how, you know, election results would be. So there you can skip it too. This is moral ambiguity on the Rohingya. So this talks about how India must break its silence on the gross human rights violations in Myanmar on the Rohingya issue. Then on the op-ed page you have the case against war on Iran. So as we see the escalation of tensions in West Asia, along with US President Donald Trump also putting pressure on Iran, sanctions being imposed against Iran after walking out of the nuclear deal with Iran. So that is, again, the article says that US military action could trigger multiple conflicts in the Gulf. On page 13, you have India, Pakistan to attend SCO meet. So this is regarding Shanghai Cooperation Organization. So the SCO meet is going to take place in Bishkek in Kyrgyzstan on 21st-22nd May. So India, for the first time since the Pulwama terror attack, is going to come together with Pakistani foreign minister. So Indian and Pakistani foreign ministers will be together attending this ministerial meet. then there's no important news on international page. It's continuation of the same US-Iran development. Then you have on the business page, third-party motor insurance premium to get pricier as IRDI revised rate cut. So this is continuation of the front page news. So third-party motor insurance premium is going to increase. So there's no change in long-term rates for new cars and two-wheelers. There's also 15% discount for private electrical vehicles. But the third-party motor insurance premium will increase. Then this is Google blocks Huawei's access to Android. So Google has suspended links with the Chinese telecom company. So this is the latest development where Huawei is being targeted and, you know, is blocked by major countries, especially USA and the Western countries. So now Google has also stopped, you know, suspended its links with it. And on page 16, you have Flash says Enfield violated patent. So this is regulator rectifier device. So this is a device which converts AC into DC in motorcycle engines. So Flash Electronics, which is an electric auto component maker, has filed a lawsuit against Royal Enfield, the motorcycle maker, for patent infringement in the US. So this is regarding this vital component for two-wheelers, regulator rectifier device. Then there is no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.